Each test step has 6 major step functions and 4 conditions that can occur during that step. The 6 major functions are forward. This causes the device controlled by the channel to move in the positive direction. Reverse. This causes the device controlled by the channel to move in the reverse direction. Wait. This will have the device connected to the channel not move. The length of the wait time is entered in the max column. Voltage set. Changes the power supply voltage. Start loop. This is used to mark the block of instructions placed between start loop and the end loop, commands that needs to be repeated. Each start loop requires 1 stop loop in the test. Stop loop. This command is used to mark the end of the repeated commands in the loop. When the stop loop command is run, it checks the conditions and the loop counter to determine whether to return to the start loop step or continue on to the next step in the test. If the loop counter has not yet reached the number of cycles column, the test returns to the start loop step. If the loop counter is complete or the condition has faulted, it continues on to the next step as well. Save. This stores a CSV file with the current trace, analog sensor data, voltage trace, and digital information for later analysis if the condition is met. Of the 4 step end conditions, there are the limit switch. The available conditions are on, which triggers the condition when the sensor is on, useful for sensing. Note that if the trigger is on when the step begins, the condition is triggered immediately. Off triggers the condition when the sensor is off. Change triggers the condition when the sensor changes from on to off or from off to on. Toggle triggers the condition when the sensor changes back to its initial state after being in a different state for any amount of time. This can be useful when you want to move past a sensor's operating position. On, off, on. Equivalent to a toggle, but only begins monitoring when the sensor is on. And off, on, off. Equivalent to a toggle, but only monitors when the sensor is off. Toggle on, which triggers the condition when the sensor either changes from off to on, or from on to off to on. This is useful when the previous step may or may not have left the part in a state where the sensor may be on. And toggle off, the opposite of toggle on. This triggers the condition when the sensor changes from on to off or from off to on to off. There's also the analog sensor. The available conditions are greater than, triggers the condition when the sensed value is greater than the target value, or less than, triggers the condition when the sensed value is less than the target value. There's also current. The current condition can only use the selected channel as a sensor. Only 1 condition type is available, designed to sense the stall of a DC motor. These 3 values should be entered. The stall target defines the current in amps at which the motor should be considered to have stalled. This should be larger than any spikes in the steady state current. The inrush time. When the motor begins moving, there may be a large spike of inrush current. The inrush time sets the duration in seconds during which the motor should ignore any spikes in a current over the stall target. And stall time. When the motor stalls, many test specifications require it to be held in the stall condition for some period of time. This parameter sets the delay in seconds after the stall target is sensed and the inrush time has elapsed, during which the tester should have kept the channel energized. The last condition is time. A common idiom in programming the tester is to enter a step with the wait function, a time mode of next, and a maximum of 0 seconds. This causes the channel to be ignored entirely for this step. The 2 parameters for the time limit condition are the maximum amount of seconds and the minimum amount of seconds. The maximum time in seconds is the time at which the condition will be triggered if the time mode is set to next. If the time mode is set to false, another condition, either limit, analog, or current, must be triggered before the max time is exceeded or the tester will generate a fault. The minimum amount of seconds is ignored if the time mode is set to next. If the time mode is set to fault and another condition on the channel is triggered before the min time is reached, the tester will generate a fault. Before the start of your test, you can specify what happens on a fault. Either the test will continue as normal, ignoring the fault, or the test will cease. Both of these can happen while still logging the faults that occur during the running of the test. During the test, graphical data will appear on the screen, giving you some feedback to the values that are being measured.